Hi, I'm Porter McRoberts, and today we're going to be doing a lumbar facet joint nerve ablation. I have a patient of mine who has happily given his consent to a video of the procedure. He's already had his right side done. For privacy purposes, we'll be calling him James Bond. Mr. Bond, do you consent to the videoing of your procedure today?
Yes, I do.
Terrific. Okay. So what we're doing is we're doing a facet joint nerve ablation. We've already done the block, which is the diagnostic test. I'm going to drop some numbing medicine here, and I just kind of want you guys to see how we go about doing this. We're just drawing up a bit of lidocaine, preservative-free, and we use a bit of it, as you can see, and we don't use that needle. It's a little aggressive. And then we'll have a little more of the numbing medicine and a little bit of the anti-inflammatory. We use catalog here at 2% lidocaine. So, get going here. So the idea is basically, what we did previously is we numbed up the nerves using just numbing medicine. And these are the nerves that go to the facet joints, so the joints in the back part of the spine. And we did that as a diagnostic step to make sure that if we were to do the ablation, that we'd have a high likelihood of having some good pain relief. Mr. Bonzara had his right side done. How do you feel, James, on the right side?
Fantastic.
Okay, terrific.
Big improvement.
Big improvement. Okay. Here's a little marker. And, what we'll do is a little numbing medicine to come. Okay, a little cold spray, Mr. Bond, followed by a little numbing medicine. A little pinch right there. Pinch, pinch, pinch. A little more numbing medicine. Doing beautifully. We do two spots, just like the other side. And total procedure time for this is about 15 minutes max. Doesn't really take long to do, but you gotta take time to make sure you do it safely. Cold spritz. So feel free to talk, Mr. Bond, if you so wish, or not if you don't.
Remember, I got my Walter PPK in my pocket.
Oh, that's right, man. What a fine a guy. what a pistol. I love Bond. My grandfather loved reading the Ian Fleming books.
Oh, right.
I mean, he was a madman for him. And he died before any of the Bond movies came out.
Oh,
that was a shame. So we're just numbing up down to the transverse process here. Just a little more numbing, a little more numbing. Okay. The main key to this is to make sure that nothing goes down the leg during the testing phase, and we'll do that here shortly. How many ablations do you think we have done together, Michelle, in your lifetime?
Hundreds?
Hundreds. I would say thousands. I'm sure we've done thousands. Because we do many hundreds a year. We do about 4 to 7 a day, probably. Maybe 2 to 7 a day. Okay, now we're going to pulse, make sure nothing goes down the leg. Here we go. You feeling pulsations there?
No.
Okay, we're gonna come down, make sure we're nothing there?
Nothing.
Okay. And nothing down the leg?
Nope.
Okay, nothing at all. That's fine. Still a little numbing already. So a little more lidocaine and then we'll get underway there.
Oh, what about that?
Not down the leg though.
No.
Let me know if it gets too intense, okay? And of course, if it ever gets down the leg. Well, that one's working, we're gonna place the second roll needle. A little deeper numbing medicine. A little more numbing, doing beautifully. More numbing, that's great.
A little pulse there.
A little pulse.
In the cheek.
In the tushy.
Mm-hmm.
A little more numbing coming your way. Key thing is to have the patient awake during this. Well, because they're very, very sensitive to their own body. They're the most sensitive monitoring equipment in the entire room. So if you put the patient to sleep, I think you're deadening the most safe monitoring you have. They're able to report on leg sensation, if they have any weakness or sensation going down their leg or pain, etc. It's the most humane way to do it and the most safe way to do it. We've been doing this for many, many years. Thank God, never a complication. Risk is defined as having a negative permanent outcome. And what are the likelihood of that? And God, we've never had a negative permanent outcome ever. Thank God, from any of our procedures ever. Sometimes you may have a little more pain afterwards that goes away temporarily. You may have a little bleeding. Possible infection. We never had an infection. I don't think there's actually ever recorded in the literature infection with an ablation. Nevertheless, specifically, we get ready to stimulate the next level here as soon as we've done our 90-second ablation. We're done with that. Now we can do our next level. A little pulsation. Mr. Bond, feeling any pulsation there?
No.
No, that's fine. Right on the spot, though. Anything there?
A little pain.
A little pain, but no pulsation.
No.
Right down to os. Nothing down the leg.
No.
Perfect. It's nice to have a little pulsation, but not necessarily. There's the branch called the medial branch, the dorsal primary ramus, has both a motor component and a sensory component. We're really not interested in ablating the motor component. It just happens to ride along with the sensory component. So, getting closer and closer. Mr. Bond. Oh. On that a little no more numbing. Mm-hmm. More numbing.
Elbow.
Good, good. Doing great. I'll let that soak in.
Walk that one down to the top.
Into the tush and hip?
And the thigh.
Okay, back or front?
Side.
Okay.
Left side.
Right in here?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine. How are we doing on time there? Good. All right. Radio frequency rhizotomy has been done for about 30 years. Started with Dr. Ray, did the Ray probe, or Ray nail. Tapped this big, looked like a roofing nail down through the skin, and put a grounding pad on you, and then wrapped the copper wire, and then a blade attached to this nail. Use a hammer to actually nail the thing into the arch of the joint between the superior articular process and the transverse process. It was highly effective. So then things got a little better over time, as you can see. It's a little more finesse now. A lot of different companies make these things. But main key is keeping the patient awake and monitoring for any leg sensation. The concern is that about a centimeter in front of where we are is the nerve that comes out and goes to the leg. And so when we stimulate a pulsation of electricity that, if it's close to that nerve, would stimulate the nerve and going down the muscle, you'd see a twitch. When it's close enough, the leg feels like a fish out of water. It's thumping around. But if you don't have that, then you really have neurophysiologic. Now here we are close to this.
Oh, I feel
right. You feel that pulsing. We're a little flatter on the nerve here, is why you're feeling that pulsing. That's good though.
That was cool.
Yeah, that's interesting. Huh? We'll probably get it at L5S1 as well. Or the S1 SAP, which is real fire. So, ablation there. You're doing beautifully.
You've got stimulated muscles. I haven't used them.
Yes. A little more numbing. How much pain did you have after the ablation on the other side, Mr. Mond?
After it?
Yes, sir.
First few hours, it went down to like a 2 or 3, and then it went down from that down to 1. I was able to walk and have hardly any pain.
At what point did you notice the difference between the right side, which had been ablated, and the left side, which hadn't yet? Did you notice the difference?
Almost immediately.
Gotcha. How much relief did you get from the diagnostic blocks that we did?
I don't think as much as I did from the ablation.
Interesting.
The diagnostic block helped, but it didn't last very long.
Gotcha. The ablations last a lot longer.
Yeah. And I was able to walk. And that's the big thing that's been bothering me is standing and walking. Sitting and laying, no problem. But standing and walking is where I get the pain.
Gotcha. All right. Well, this is almost concludes. We've got one more nerve to do. This is being the L5 nerve on the left side. Appreciate you guys spending the time watching this. Anything down the leg?
Nope.
Just right in the tush?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. So thank you very much, Porter McRoberts. Signing off. Thanks.